Well, it happened again. Another big name content creator tweeted out about a Halo Battle Royale, which started a lot of conversation about the topic. Though, should we really give enough credibility to these people? We'll stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another news and informational video when it comes to Halo. If you like these kind of videos and want to see some more content like this, make sure you tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. If you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo as we ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, make sure you tap subscribe. So let's get right into the content here. So the content creator Courage, or Courage if you want to call him that, tweeted this out recently. At Halo, I've played Halo since 2005. It's my favorite game series of all time. If Halo Infinite doesn't release with a robust and well-made Battle Royale game mode, then it will be one of the greatest gaming failures in history. Have a good day. You guys all know who Courage is. He's a well-known content creator within mostly YouTube and Twitch. Recently made the switch from Twitch over to YouTube because of a contract that he signed with YouTube. Made his name through Call of Duty and then also kind of blew up with Fortnite. So essentially just kind of bouncing between those two games, mainly focusing on the Battle Royale side of stuff as well. Now, I will take him at his word saying he's been playing since 2005. I can imagine maybe not so much, probably in the last few years. Though I feel like the bigger argument about this whole thing, it's not exactly about this tweet itself, but it's more just about known content creators within the social media community as a whole for like Twitch and YouTube and all those other platforms. The argument here is really, should we really listen to these large name content creators? I mean, they are certainly influential when it comes to gaming as a whole, as the whole social media side of thing when it comes to gaming has become more and more important over the years. It has been statistically shown that people who watch content on live stream content, specifically like on Twitch, are more likely to play that game and stay with that game for a longer time, increasing the engagement. So when you have big name people like Courage, Dr. Disrespect, Ninja even, and other kind of content creators out there playing your game, that is absolutely massive and huge for the success of your game as well. Games like Among Us have become hugely popular because of streaming. And content creation as a whole, as it showcases what you can do with this game and why is it fun, why they're making content on it, and it should probably inspire a lot of people to jump on that bandwagon as well. Though this is a double-edged sword, because you have that one side where you want those big name people playing your game, promoting it, and showing how much fun you can have. But on the other side of that sword, you need to make sure that the game that you release fits what you're trying to accomplish with it. Because you don't want to create a game catered specifically for streamers, because obviously that might not lead to the best gameplay for the franchise of Halo. Though many prominent members of the gaming community as a whole and Halo community did reply to this post with some interesting takes. Esports commentator Halo Fan said, "It could also just be a good multiplayer game too, right? I feel like that's a bit higher on my list than a BR. Like, sure, make a BR, but if the game ain't good, then it doesn't matter if it has a BR or not." Courage replies back saying, "Not gonna lie, Alex, I don't even mention those things because I fully expect them as someone who already loves Halo. I just mentioned this because it will bring Halo a brand new audience. That's what the franchise needs on top of already existing player base." To me, this really kind of touches on actually one of my biggest fears when it comes to Halo Infinite as a whole, right? If it doesn't release with a Battle Royale, right? And Halo releases, and it's like a really good Halo game, like a really, really good Halo game. Are people really gonna stick with it? Are new people gonna come to the game? I mean, Halo is an old franchise. By the time Halo Infinite releases, Halo as a franchise will be 20 years old. So if you're a gamer, you most likely know what Halo is and what it's about, and probably have already figured if it's for you. Say for example with the band Metallica, right, and they released the song Enter Sandman. There's plenty of people out there who don't like that song, right, and probably never listened to Metallica ever since then, but then never listened to anything past Enter Sandman and all the other great songs they've released since then, because they know it's Metallica and they don't really care to listen to that band. I'm afraid the same thing might happen with Halo. Obviously, gaming is a little bit different than the music genre, but you can kind of see where I'm coming from. Another very prominent Twitch streamer and content creator, Nick Merckx, just tweeted louder. That's because back in November of 2020, he tweeted out this saying, "Halo, how do you guys not have a battle royale yet? So much potential." Even some Halo pros like Ace were here said, "It doesn't make any sense if it doesn't launch with one." Another Halo pro, Trippy, said, "Couldn't have said it any better, Jack." Harris Heller, well known for his stream beats, copyright-free music, and large YouTube channel, just had the prayer hand saying, basically saying, "Please bring a battle royale to Halo." So this does show that there are prominent members within the gaming community as a whole, very prominent members, who would love to see a battle royale come to Halo, which would certainly boost the popularity of the game franchise as a whole. And trust me, 343 recognizes this. Previously, Sketch actually ran a community poll on his Twitter just for funsies, about what the community as a whole would like for a battle royale in Halo. Should it happen? Should it not? This is what he said right here, saying, "Just for fun, do you think a battle royale mode has a place in a Halo game?" And it was a rather even split, with it being 35%, heck no, maybe with 36, and heck yeah for 29%. Obviously, it's a small sample size with just under 8,000 votes for that poll, but you can kind of see that it's a mixed review. Some people want it, some people don't want it, and you know, some people are kind of on the fence with it. Though it seems like a lot of these big name content creators really want to see Halo get into the battle royale genre or field, if you want to call it that. Nashot said specifically, "Halo purists don't want battle royale to be integrated into their franchise. Do you really believe Halo Infinite will succeed without capturing this massive wave of new generation players that have only grown up with BR titles? Call of Duty is a perfect example." And even the Doc himself back in 2018 said, "Dear Halo, you are perfect for Battle Royale. Sincerely, Dr. Disrespect." So it seems like the want is there. I feel like there was enough popularity of the mode itself to justify creating it, at least for what we've seen right now with the minimal user research that we've seen for anecdotal evidence and some polls. I know a lot of people have probably already typed this in the comment section, but there are two things that we definitely do need to talk about when it comes to a Halo Battle Royale. One is the comment from Jeff Easterling, because he said on a Mixer stream, I believe about 3 years ago now at this point, saying, "I'll tell you right now, the only BR we're interested in is the battle rifle, the original battle rifle, so calm yourself." This was also in the early planning stages of Halo Infinite when the development really kind of first started coming around, and I think they really wanted to focus on just making a good Halo game. But we've seen the atmosphere of gaming and how battle royale is here to stay. It stayed around for a long time.
And do you feel like anything has changed with the development of Halo Infinite in the last 3 years or so? I would say a lot has changed.
And honestly, it started back with DayZ mod, where it essentially played out like a battle royale for like the end game part of DayZ. And yeah, we've seen a bunch of copycat BR games that kind of came by, went away, but the main ones that have stayed with us are Fortnite, Apex Legends, Warzone, and PUBG as well. But think of it like this, guys. It's been over a year now at this point since Warzone's been out. A lot of people have been playing mainly like Apex, Warzone, and Fortnite, and I think that a lot of people are really looking forward to the next battle royale or some kind of new mode that can really rejuvenate the gaming community as a whole. And I think if Halo releases a battle royale, well, it would be the perfect time for it to really pop up, because you know, people have played enough Fortnite, people have played a good amount of Apex Legends since 2019, and I know a lot of people are kind of starting to get a little bored of Warzone at this point. They kind of know what to expect with that franchise. So what would be the next big shot in the arm for the battle royale game mode as a whole? I think a Halo battle royale would certainly be that shot. Now, another argument I see a lot of times is saying, just give people the ability to make stuff in Forge. Well, I actually had a conversation with Infinite Forges, who is a very prominent forger and knows a lot about the forging feature as a whole, and said this about being able to make a battle royale within Halo, because he did that with Halo 5. "You've created a battle royale in Forge. What would you say to that statement?"
I think that it's awesome that we have the ability to create something that advanced. I mean, you got to think about it. The fact that you have such a limited feature, which is, it's definitely limited when you compare it to other map creators out there, but for what it is, it's incredible that Halo 5 was able to deliver on such a tool, right, for map making. However, it's definitely not easy. It takes a lot of time, a lot of patience, a lot of effort, and I do believe that it's incredibly cool that we have the opportunity, but nothing is really going to match the quality of something dev made.
Of course, we haven't really seen anything about Halo Infinite's Forge, but I think this really just kind of reiterates that there's always going to be some kind of limitations with user side content creation that you will never be able to fully get that true developer amount of customization that you can have from a developer made Battle Royale map compared to a Forge made Battle Royale map. Developer tools are always going to be better. So let's say Halo Infinite does have a Battle Royale. How should it come into the franchise? I think at launch for Halo Infinite, you launch a solid Halo title without a Battle Royale, just to ease off a lot of the nerves of the members of the community right now. Because I feel like within the community, it's about 50-50, but I think within gaming as a whole, it's probably more in favor of a Battle Royale for Halo. But what this does, right, if you release just a solid Halo game at first, it gives 343 time to update the game, release patches, change some weapons around, because that's going to happen with the launch of Infinite. It's not going to be perfect. But what really needs to be perfect is the launch of the Battle Royale for Halo. So why not give it some time, let the community provide feedback on weapon tunings and just game patches as a whole. So when that Battle Royale does come in, it has a much more refined sandbox experience. So then you can just bring in a new map that changed some spawn times and randomize some things, and you have a really awesome Battle Royale day one ready to go. And you can release that Battle Royale in Q1, so like in spring of 2022, or in the fall, like for Q4 for 2022 as well. I think it would be great times for that to happen. But let me know in the comment section down below, what are your thoughts on a Battle Royale of Halo? I'm sure many people probably already did without watching this entire video, but if you have made it to the end, I want to hear what you guys have to say about it. So thank you so much for watching, I greatly appreciate it. Check out the videos on the screen right here if you missed any content from me recently, and I'll catch you on the next video. Peace out.